India is getting ready to test its Agni-V intercontinental ballistic missile, ICBM, in its final operational configuration from Wheeler Island off Odisha after 2 years. Defense sources said preparations were on in full swing to launch the nuclear-capable Agni-V from its canister on a launcher truck towards December end or early January. There were some minor technical snags in Agni-V, which required tweaking of its internal battery and electronic configurations after its last test in January 2015, a source said. The impending fourth test of Agni-V, capable of striking even the northernmost parts of China, is in itself significant. This will be the final test of the three-stage Agni-V, which will be tested for its full range, before the Strategic Forces Command, SFC, begins its user trials, the source said. The Tri-Service SFC, established in 2003 to manage India's nuclear arsenal, will conduct at least two tests before the missile is produced in adequate numbers for induction. While Agni-V was tested in an open configuration in April 2012 and September 2013, the third test, in January 2015, saw a beam fired from a hermetically sealed canister mounted on a Tatra launcher truck. The missile's canister launch version makes it even deadlier since it gives the armed forces requisite flexibility to swiftly transport and fire the 50-ton missile from anywhere they want. Once the Agni-V is inducted, India will join the super-exclusive club of countries with ICBMs, missiles with a range of over 5,000 to 5,500 kilometers, alongside the US, Russia, China, France and the UK. Apart from the short-range Prithvi and Danush missiles, the SFC has inducted the Agni-1, Agni-2 and Agni-3 missiles. While these missiles are mainly geared towards Pakistan, the Agni-4 and Agni-5 are specifically meant for deterrence against China. China, of course, is leagues ahead in terms of its missile and nuclear arsenals. But the Indian Defence Establishment believes the Agni-5 is sufficient to take care of existing threat perceptions. As earlier reported, DRDO has also done some work on developing maneuvering warheads or intelligent re-entry vehicles to defeat enemy ballistic missile defense systems, as well as MIRS, multiple independently targetable re-entry vehicles, for the Agni missiles. An MIRV payload basically means a single missile is capable of carrying several nuclear warheads, each programmed to hit different targets. Thanks for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe.